Alright, what's happening everybody? Welcome back to some more Far Cry 4! Sit back, strap in, and let Hertz entertain for the next 30 minutes, yes. Anyway, we're back at, what's it called? The Project something. Some sort of school. The last outpost that I took down. And we're back here. I did have a couple of activities left here that needed to be completed. I'm gonna get to those this episode. I did all my buying and selling, so that's all taken care of. I would like to take a quick look at the map, though. Try and give you all a rough outline of what you can probably expect here. I'm gonna hit up, we've got the assassination, we've got the Karat Fashion Week, for Mumu Chiffon, hunting a rare animal. And then, well, beyond that, I mean, those shouldn't take too long. And then beyond that, well, we've got Willis in the area, we've also got Yogi and Reggie waiting back at the galley homestead, as far as, options for various missions go. I'm not seeing anything else Golden Path up there just yet, neither am I seeing anything from Herc, so nothing yet, but we do have Shangri-La out there as well. Anyway, the one last thing that I had noticed when I was in here looking around, there is a bomb defusing mission here. Now this could be, you know, this could be going, we could be working at the Rockin' Brick Factory, you know, this thing right here. I'm not sure how you would pronounce that. The Rokan. You know what? It sounds best. The Rockin' Brick Factory. Clearly, when the brick factory is a rockin', you don't come a knockin'. Yes. Anyway, probably gonna get to that though. It's a little ways to the south, but I think I'll probably hit that this episode too. Broke down. He'll have to get it repaired. All right. Well, let's roll with the assassination first.
I hear you need a quick job.
A kill, yes. The target's going to get his vehicle repaired, so we won't have long. I'll mark the shop on your map. You'll need to sneak in and take him out without being seen.
I can do that.
I knew I could count on you. Oh, one last thing.
What?
Hide the body if you can. We need as much time as possible before they discover it.
Good.
Oh, take his dog tags.
Of course. I'm well aware. What were they doing with all... Are these a bunch of books? Bunch of school books? What are those, the yellow pages? What the hell is happening here? Were they getting ready to have a little bonfire? A little book burning session? Pagan Min style? Goddamn, I don't know. I don't know. Anyway, let's take a look at the map, see exactly where I need to get to. Oh, we're not far. I could probably just set off on foot here. It is 300 meters, but you know what? Screw it. Got a bit of a hill to climb. I want to approach as stealthily as possible. Oh, damn. Goddamn, get out of here, bro. Anyway. So yeah, we'll do the assassination, we'll come back, we'll do Karat Fashion Week, we'll set off south for the bomb defusing mission, and then, I don't know, maybe head back towards the galley homestead for Yogi and Reggie. Actually, the smart choice would probably be to head Willis's way, head for Karate International, and get a new mission with him, since it's definitely a little bit closer than Yogi and Reggie. Alright, here we go. Looks like we're rolling right up on it now. Gain the high ground. Engage down, see if we can't spot the big boss man. So, he is getting his car, his vehicle repaired here. I'm not seeing anything in the garage. Seeing a guy. He won't seem to pop up. There we go. Oh, there's a pair there. Alright, well, that second guy's working on a vehicle. I don't know. This is a terrible vantage point. What else do I have here? We got a bush over there. I could just try and circle in around this way, but there's a lot of tree cover over here. You know? Oh, dang. Oh, he hasn't arrived. Okay, I got you. He hasn't arrived yet. That must be him. You know? Laying in on the horn. The only vehicle in this, in all of Karat, that has a functional horn is that sucker right there. That's why he's the commander. Yes. Alright. Oh, look at this. Could perhaps mount this vehicle and get a good vantage point on things. There he is. Having words with the mechanic. Actually, the mechanic giving him one hell of a hard time. Oh, look at this. Opportunity for little fireworks. All right, what else? Oh. Well then. I actually feel, you know, I'm feeling like taking down the entire crew is what I'm feeling like doing. But we'll try and start with the commander. Oh, got the wrong guy's attention. That's not good. Woke up Sleeping Beauty there. If he comes right around the corner, it's, well, you know what? Let's get one more stone in there.
I know I heard something.
Just a couple more steps, sir. And I'll put you out of your misery.
Is it done yet? Not yet.
Okay. I better hide the body. Alright. Get my throwing knives ready here. Oh yeah, here we go. I got this now. I got this now. He's done. He is so done, he doesn't even know it yet. Well, of course he wouldn't know it, would he? Gonna find out here the hard way, though, isn't he? Yes, he is! Dodge. Suck and dodge. Damn it. Alright, what do I need? I have the dog tags. Need to put them in a proper hiding spot, though, apparently. And they're not really giving me some great locations here. Look at this mess. Oh my god. That's so foolish. this makes no sense whatsoever, but fine, I will complete it all, get the bonus objective here. I'll even take down this man. You know, maybe I'll just work over the crew. I don't know. I didn't like the way this guy's looking. Oh no, we're okay. We're okay. God damn it, are you kidding me? Through the window, loving it, straight into the ear, brained with some great throwing knife action. And we'll leave the one guy. We'll leave the one guy alive. Alright. Well, actually, I've got all the bodies hidden really well here, you know? When you think about it. I might as well loot some guys up. Got a little trucker speed there. Again, always, I always feel like I'm hard up for cash now in this game. Alright. Alright, the one guy with his nose to the grindstone. In there working on changing a tire. Or putting on some new brakes or something. And there we have it. He'll finish his shift, he'll be looking around, he'll be like, God damn those slackers, always taking off early. Leaving me to do all the work. Oh, got such a primo opportunity here too, look at that. Look at that. I'm gonna leave it though. I think I'm gonna hop on that ATV. And just clear on out. Screw it. One guy left alive, you know. Although the opportunity was there for just a great final kill. But that's okay. I like the idea of him wondering what the hell just happened to everybody. You know, and then him showing up the next day and then nobody's there. And that's when he finally does go checking out the bushes and the corners of the property. Looking to see where the slackers are hiding. And then he finds all the dead bodies. I'll tell you, this ATV is taking a beating here. Taking a good thumping as a dude come barreling down that hill. Alright. Nice. You know what? That's what I've got my repair torch for, too. Look at this. Oh, loving it. I could have taken the ATV back to the garage and had it fixed up. That's what I should have done. That's why I left that one fella alive, clearly. Do I need anything? I don't think so. Alright, here we go. Mumu Chiffon, Corrupt Fashion Week. Good, sir. Good.
He sounded like a real pain in the ass.
More like a diseased elephant cock in my ass, but not anymore. Thank you.
I'll tell you, we've got a little loot here. Might as well go up and grab it. I could have sworn I cleaned this camp up. Anyway, that's fine. Alright, here we go. What are we hunting this time? Oh my god. Just get out there and kill Gulo, the rare honey badger from Mr. Chiffon. You know, clearly the rare honey badger should be worth much more than 27,000. Yes. Try tacking another two on the front of that. Anyway. Yes, I'm absolutely positive. Are you mad? The game asks me. Oh no, you know what? It could be. Oh no, you know what it's going to be? It's going to be that damn albino badger. Any last words? Not really. Let's just do it.
Mr. Chiffon, I found your latest design. It's a...
breathtaking? Sensational?
It looks like a bag made out of a honey badger.
Rare honey badger. Rare. The fiercest. Yes, I know. We've all heard the rumors. And nasty, they don't give a shit. I could go on, but I won't. It's passé. So last year. Just get out there and kill that badger.
All right, let's do it. I wonder what, you know what, if I have to take this thing on with a bow, it's not actually telling me what I need to kill it with. I guess that is a green leaf. It looks like a white leaf to me. Anyway, I'm definitely gonna need the green leaves, aren't I, for this encounter. Now, I have a feeling, you know, being that it's rare, it's gonna be the albino. Gulo will be the albino damn badger, and as I recall from my exploits in the arena, those albino badgers, well, they were an angry bunch. They took several, you know, just shotgun rounds, pistol rounds, and very little damage was sustained. All right, here we go. Got my staging area. Oh, God. God, they're giving me some proper weaponry against this thing. Thank God it's not a bow or a machete or something ridiculous like that. Anyway, I'll take my PKM or whatever the hell it is. My LMG and go on the hunt. But yeah, and they'll nip you. They'll take one bite. Oh my god, they did in a rhino. Well, it's just gonna be one. It's just gonna be Gulo, but I would imagine he's got a little posse with him, seeing as he's King Albino Badger of these parts. Look at this. They've turned these the villagers that used to live here, that used to come here and I don't know, pray or whatever to the shrine. They turned them into nothing more than a pile of bones. Even put down a wolf. She was trying to feed on the scraps. I can hear one. But yeah, they'll nip for like two bars of health. Oh, look at this guy. Oh, here we go. They'll nip for like two bars of health. You know what I need? Not that. Oh no, run it. Sorry, sir. It's you or it's gonna be me or it's gonna be you. And if the choice is mine, it's gonna be you, yes. Definitely gonna work the levels here. He doesn't stand a chance. I've outwitted you, albino badger of death, yes. And what I actually wanted to do... get the survival syringe in. Now what I think happens is I take less damage and do more damage. At the very least, I take less damage. And he's done. And there we go. Okay, he was a bit of a pushover for me at this stage in the game, you know. I'm just too powerful for the mighty beast. We get a good look at him here for the first time. I was always under pressure in the arena, so I never did get a good look at them, but yeah, he's got that albino look to him, you know. All right, there we go. That's it. I'm surprised he didn't have a posse, but I guess when you're this ferocious, you don't need one. No. He used to have a posse, and then he ate them. Not only did he eat them, he went and he hunted down all of their families as well. Yes. Wiped out every generation of badger in the area. Alright, anyway, I don't know. Just spewing nonsense at this point. Oh my god! Look at them all! I walk in there, I'm dead. You know? I don't know how you could possibly walk in there without firing a weapon off, you know? Oh no, have they all stirred? Yay. Just just mow them all down. Screw that mess. I thought they lived in there. That's just creepy. I don't like it. Goddamn snakes all over the place. Alright. What do we have here now? That looks like a stormer. It is, I think. Well, no, it's that type of weapon, but I don't think it's the actual SIG version of it. Anyway, we'll do a quick weapon swap here. I'll give this a go for the time being. And, I think I'm probably good. Hopefully he won't bother with me now. No space rock action. I think when they're all slithering like that, they're trying to flee. And they won't pose any sort of threat. I could be wrong about that. Sir, you should probably just clear out of the area, you know? It's not the friendliest. I mean, look at this. That little bastard of a badger was doing in tigers, decimating the wildlife in this particular neck of the woods. Anyway, at this point, what are we gonna do? I've got the ATV right there. I could wingsuit it, but I, you know what? I've got a bit of a jaunt ahead of me if I want to get down to this this next mission that I want to hit up. And we've got a Pagan's Wrath right there. I could take to the skies, you know, wingsuit it. I'm not too high up though. I won't be able to carry it too far. I probably would be best to hop on the ATV. So we'll do that. What I was thinking, I don't think I clarified my thought. You know, I saw the Pagan's Wrath and I thought, wow, wouldn't it be cool to come wingsuiting in, you know, above the Pagan's Wrath action, and you know, drop in on them that way, and then do them in all in one slick movement, you know, the aerial assault. On Pagan's Wrath, oh my god, would be exquisite. Yes, make for great episode gameplay. But no, just didn't have the elevation required to really carry the wingsuit to such a far off destination. Anyway, it looks like we got a bit of an elevation shift happening up here. I better be careful pushing forward. Nice, slowing her. Oh, look at this. Goddamn, up on two wheels. He's all jammed up on something here. Had zero bloody torque there. Not sure what was happening. Alright. Pop off here, galley. How we doing? Looks like they took care of business on their own. But I did try. I did try, y'all. I don't even get the karma for it. Didn't even get a round off, you know. They're about to get done in by this eagle, though. You can tell the eagle's already circling. Scouting out a meal. Oh, dang. Hold on to it here, galley. Where are you going, sir? This has been a bit of a funky ride. Not as clean as I would have liked it to have been. But we're not really wrecking. It's just... the terrain, she's a little unpredictable right now. Actually, now we're starting to beam. Beam a few trees here and there. Alright, some wild brawl cutting through the field. Run them over, galley! Yes, there you go. Got one of them. Alright, we're rolling right up on it, so that wasn't too far. And a fun little ride in the ATV. Damn it, sir, you're gonna pop your tires driving it on the fire like that. Goddamn. Alright, sir. What's up? What's up, my homie? Good. Come here, quick. All right, the Royal Army has sent a demolition squad to a nearby location. We're not actually given the location
Why
yet.
Why should I care?
Noor has destroyed all the ancient karate scriptures she can find, but one monk has protected a cache that he shipped to the Golden Path.
And you want me to go get them?
Yes, and if you don't, they are lost.
All right, all right.
I knew you would do the right thing.
Well, of course. I always try to do the right thing, sir. Doesn't always work out that way. But I certainly try. Alright, I guess I should probably hit the map. Take a look around. It actually looks like we're heading back towards the arena. That's the vibe I'm getting here. Let me take a look. No, we're heading for the Rock and Brick Factory. Spectacular. Let's go rock out at the Rock and Brick Factory. Yes. Oh, you know what? This has to be done with a measure of stealth, doesn't it? Alright, I better chill on my approach here. That's no good. Clearly, you've chilled far. You've gone beyond chill there, galley, with that. Running into that tree. Gone beyond chill. You're completely frozen. Alright, here we go. Defuse all bombs without being detected. What are we looking at out there? Real long range opportunity here for this. That's what I'm talking about. Not missing a step. I'm missing a step with that knife throw. Let's figure out what I'm walking into here. I think that's probably my best choice. I've got these serums. I collect these damn flowers. I might as well get some use out of them. Here we go.
Find the source of the danger and eliminate it.
Bullshit. Dang it. Oh no. Come on, galley, what are you doing? Like, when it rains, it pours, clearly. Alright, I got this goddamn shock trooper with a shotgun chasing me down, you punk. Give it a rest. Well, I got two of them. Missed the third, unfortunately. Alright, this is a little trickier than I initially thought. I thought I'd be able to get up on that little rooftop of the actual factory and just take care of that squad pretty quickly. But there's a lot of guys that have that scoped out, apparently. And again, I'm forced to replay one of these bomb defusal missions. Unfortunately. I don't know if going up here right off the get-go is the best choice. I'll give it a shot though. I'm definitely pulling bodies away from the edges though. Loving it. Alright, looking pretty good now. Let me get the syringe in, have a good look around. See what I'm walking into, yeah. Nobody's really clued in. I don't know how I botched this so terribly. And look at this. You know what? I probably could have saved the joint. Even when the shit hit the fan. Had I simply been a little bit more attentive. And been aware that there was a bomb up here. I was thinking about maybe going to my explosive arrows and doing that guy in. Getting everybody else to kind of turn around. This method should work as well, though. Done. I think somebody saw a dead body and is closing in. You can see we've got a heavy, it looks like, walking into the area here. We'll put that there.
I will have my revenge.
And hopefully that'll draw him right into the mine. And I won't even have to think twice about him.
What
I'll tell you, that was a beauty shot. That's, you know, it's always nice when I can pull them off without really thinking about it much. Often when I sit there and I think about it and him and haw about it and try and discern, you know, if I've got the right lead and the right distance, that's when I'm going to mess up the shot, you know. But when it's just natural, you just go with instinct and off feel, you know, that's when you hit it clean. And it's real nice when you do. Oh, loving it. And there we go. And that's that. Third one disarmed. That heavy still wandering around. Kind of disappointed. I didn't actually get him there. You know, I've got that one mine. Amazingly, just the luckiest goddamn heavy alive, isn't he? Yes, he is. As he has completely bypassed it like a true professional. You know? I got something. You try bypassing this here, sucker. There we go, and that's that. That's all she wrote. Go back to my normal arrows, and let's search him up. Search up a few bodies here, in fact. I want some loot, you know. I want a nice payday, you know, because not only are they giving me loot, and this is something I've been neglecting a bit. I have to admit. They give you loot for sale, and then I get a little money as well, so... It makes it worth it. I just want to get the bankroll. I want to get the wallet filled again, you know. Be able to buy myself a few weapons. Well, what's happening here? Is it not complete? Do I have to leave the area, perhaps? I'm not sure. Yeah, I did them, man. With the takedown. So they've been cleanly looted. Alright, well, let me just drive on out of here. I didn't remember seeing any sort of pop-up. There we go. And we're on the road for Willis now. I don't know how much time I've got left on the tail end of this. Should have paid closer attention to the time I booted the sucker up. I think maybe 10 minutes, you know. Maybe 10 minutes at the most. We could be running long as far as I know at this point. There's Sherpa right there. I think I'll stop in with him. Because I am carrying that one assault rifle that I don't really want. If anything, I'd want the SIG version of it. You know, there we go, 92,000. That's what I'm talking about. We're up to 5 grand here. We're getting somewhere again. Let's refill that. And body armor is looking okay. SIG web. Should I grab the Stormer? What was I carrying? You know, I had the F1. I had the F1 for a reason. You know, I like having the bow, but then I like having something that is silenced to go along with it. So I've got options, and I think I will go back to the F1. I wasn't finished using it. I had to put it away for... What did I put it away for? Oh, I put it away for that damn... for GULO. The honey badger of death. Alright. Let's see, how far is Willis from here? Now, I kind of got out of the truck because I saw the mask coming. I saw the Sherpa. I think I will go for the mask. And, I don't know. I guess it would probably be best just to stay mobile. Stay in the vehicle. I'll tell you, these damn trucks, they've got a mind of their own. I don't know what the truck is doing. Keeps wanting to steer to the right for some reason. I don't know, I gotta get out of it. It's clearly messed up. The steering's... the alignment is off or something, I don't know. Goddamn. Alright. Find this damn mask. There we go. Quick and to the point. I would like to find the write-up. Where's the message left by the goat? Perhaps there wasn't one. Oh no, here we go. Nope. Nothing there. Well, screw it then. Oh, that was real close. That was real close. I think I'm just gonna leave that truck. They seem faulty, those damn... Well, I guess that's not even drivable, that thing. That old heap. I should commandeer this vehicle. Alright, anyway, let's see if I can get to Willis before I need to wrap this episode. My boy, Robbie Ray Rana, yes.
Is attacking nomad camps throughout Kirat. Great move, you guys. Yeah, wait
a what is this here? A little courier action? What? Oh, done. Done, sucker.
I mean, think of the nomads. They sleep in tents every night.
Y'all know what I'm playing. What's happening here? I'll take it. Shame that I botched those two arrows, but well, what can you do? Come on, chase me down the hill, sucker. I got a surprise waiting for you down at the base. Oh. He's got... Oh. What did he grab? He got a boar over there. I knew the eagle was coming in for something. And now this boar quite displeased with what the eagle's done. Can't take his aggression out on the eagle, so he'll do it to the next best thing. And he's trying to spear me. He's trying to gore me. With his little baby tusks, yes. He's an angry, a spitting mad little wild boar, isn't he? Yes, he is. All right. Well, you know what? I really don't think that by the time I get up here, I'm gonna have much more time left to do anything. I wish I'd been paying better attention. Goddamn, am I ever paying good attention to the time I start these things? No. If you've been around here, you know that that's like a truth of most of my series. That's a fact. That's a given. You can. What the hell? Goddamn snake attacking me. Get out of here, sugar. Unbelievable. I never jumped there. Freaking me right out. Alright, we'll make the climb. At least, you know what, I think I'll try and at the very least I'll go and have words with Willis. Often when I'm struggling to remember what time I started. And often when that happens, I try to think, well, how much have we done, you know? We've done a fair bit, but it was all relatively compact, wasn't it? Failed the one, but I failed it pretty quickly. I don't know. What is it, a bunch of piggies out here? And a honey badger, and you know what, I need a honey badger skin. Yeah, there's a couple of pigs, but I think there's a boar over there as well. Looking to cause trouble. Boar with an attitude. Getting spotted by something. What does, has the Royal Army resupplied the lines up here? Goddamn. I don't know. Alright. Karma vent right up here. God damn. Here comes Galley to save the day. Coming in rat sneaky too. Rat sneaky like, yes. How am I getting spotted? Unbelievable. Alright, now where... There's a ladder right over here. Oh my god. Are you kidding me? I don't have a clue how he's hitting me. Shooting me through the goddamn wall, clearly. Oh my god. I don't know what's happening. He's invisible over there. God damn it, I can't compete with that. I'm out here. I'm taking to the trenches. I'm curious, quite curious, in fact, to see where these crossover points spill out, you know. Something that was kind of lost on me when we were last up here. And that's clearly all bugged out. Can't go anywhere near that control tower right now. Gonna have to get, like, a fresh boot in on the game or something. He's clearly inside the building. Like, I don't know what's happened. I kept thinking, well, maybe he's up on the roof, you know. Maybe he's up on top of the control tower. Raining down a little death, but there's no way he should have been able to spot me. So, clearly he's like, he's inside the building, but can, but has perfect line of sight through the walls. You know? Anyway. Oh, another badger in the area. Might as well do his ass in. I do need the skin. I owe you my life. Of course you do, sir. Of course you do. Okay, well that would have made sense. You know, clearly there's just a secondary trench over here. Oh, where's Willis? He's right in the plane. All right. Well, maybe I'd better not queue this up if this is some sort of... Is this perhaps just some sort of farewell mission? Is he getting ready to leave the island? Maybe. I guess I'd have to get in the plane with him. Well, this is clearly something that's going to have to wait for next episode. And I will queue it up then. For the time being, I guess we're going to be cutting this one maybe a little bit short. I'm not really sure. But, yeah, I don't have time to start some big... Oh my god, some big thing with Willis at this point. Appreciate y'all stopping by. I hope you had a good time. Hopefully we're not running too short here, though. I hope to see you in the next one. You should tune in. You know, we're taking off. We're taking flight here with Willis. And that usually ends in some sort of good time. And, well, I hope to see you there. But, of course, until then, do not forget and always remember why it hurts. Later, all.